I just created one folder with a name as numbers. Go inside this folder. Create two folders. src. And classes. All Java files. I will be developing in SRC. Every class file will keep in the classes folder. Inside SRC, let's go for a simple Java file. Let us give a name as a B1. You can treat like a basic.
So is this the first class?
Inside SRC, I'm saving B1.java. First and foremost one, let us see divided by operator. Let's go for 1, 2, 3 is a number, then divided by 10. What is the output of this code? It's very simple. Number 1, 2, 3 divided by 10. Let's compile and run this program. One, two, three divided by 10. Everybody can understand what is going on. 1, 2, 3 divided by 10. It's not a difficult. Let us copy same program. Go to the B2. Basics 2. Save it. Let's go for 100. 1, 2, 3 divided by 10. You can easily understand what could be the output. Let's compile a little. You can see one. Number 1, 2, 3 divided by 100. You got the result as a 1. 1 only printed. Let's see one more example. B3. Let's go for number as 456 divided by 10 divided by 100 divided by 1000. B3.java. 456 divided by 10 divided by 100 divided by 1000. You can easily understand what is the output of this program. 456 divided by 10, we are getting 45. Divided by 100, we will be getting 4. Divided by 456.
Present, ma'am. Present, ma'am. Absent.
4, 5, 2, then 0. Divided by operator, it's not at all difficult to understand.
Guys, what are people doing, man? Seriously, his voice is so muffling over here. I'm not able to hear anything.
B4.
So, this is how we're going to learn.
Two more. Sorry, three more digits.
How to do that, dude? I don't know.
The original number also I will be printing. The original number. Initial number, then removing one digit through divided by 10, removing two digits through divided by 100, removing three digits through divided by 1000, removing four digits divided by 10,000. The last digits, either 1 or 2 or 3, easily can be removed through divided by. Let us try to compile and run. You can see. This is the
guys, can number. Anyone let me know, is
if
it the first
divided by 10, 3 remove. If you go for divided by 100, 1 and 2 remove. If you go for divided by 1000, 1, 2, 3 remove. If you go for divided by 10,000, 6, 1, 2, 3 got removed. 4, 5, 6. So divided by 10, divided by 100, 1000, 10,000. The last one digit, if you want to remove, go for 10. Last two digits, if you want to remove, go for 100. Last three digits, go for 1000. Divided by operator, with 10 multiples, divided by operator, with 10 multiples, it is keep different. Digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's see one more example in the same grounds. Big 5. I'll choose one variable int number. Let's go for 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 5 digits number. Let's go for num divided by 10, num divided by 100, 1000, 10,000. Finally, you can print num. B5. Num is a variable. We are printing the num. We are printing the num. Num divided by 10, num divided by 100, 1000, 10,000. Please observe, num is not reinitialized. Num remains 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 only. Num is not reinitialized. It is not reinitialized. It will be remains 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What we are doing here? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 divided by 10. You will be getting 5, 6, 7, 8. Divided by 100 means 2 digits will be removing. You will get 5, 6, 7. You will be getting 3 digits removing 5, 6, 4 digits removing 5. If you wanted, you can go for one more. B5. Let's compile and run. These are very simple. Any person can able to understand. Not only CSE student, anybody can able to understand. Num is not changed. Num remains the same. Num is remains the same. So int num. What we are considering? Num divided by 10. divided by 100, divided by 1000, 10,000, and 1.3. Finally, num we are printing. It is not modifying. Let's see similar kind of one more example. Let's go for int num 1 divided by 10. Small thing. Num divided by 10. These and all very, very simple. You can just print num and num 1, num 2, num 3, num 4. It's a hello world example. It's not a difficult. Everybody can understand. B6 dot sharp. Please observe one simple point here. Num is not reinitialized. Num remains the same. Num is not reinitialized. Num will be 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What could be the num 1? You can see 5, 6, 7, 8. What could be the num 2? What could be the num 2? 5, 6, 7. Why? Because divided by 100. Num 3, 5, 6. Num 4, just 5. If you want, you can go for num 5 also. So num is not modifying. Num remains the same. You can see. Num remains the same. Go for num 1. Go for num 2, 3, 4, 5. So for the num 5, add one more 0. If you want to remove last one digit, go for divided by 10. If you want to remove last two digits, divided by 100. If you want to remove last three digits, divided by 1000. So num remains the same, num 1, num 2, finally num 5, finally num 5, it is a C. So copy the same. So here int num is a one variable. Please observe. Int num is one variable. I can go for num is equal to num divided by 10, then printing the num. So please observe, every time num is reinitializing, here initially num was 5 to 9, then it is 5 to 8, come on, then it is 5 to 7, 5 to 6, then 5, reinitializing every time. Num divided by 10. The result will be 5 to 8, assigning back to num. So num will be 5 to 8. This 5 to 8 divided by 10, come on, you will be getting 5 to 7, that is back, assigning to num, 5 to 7. 5 to 7 divided by 10, you will be getting 5 to 6. This 5 to 6 divided by 10, you will be getting a 5. Same number reinitializing. Same number. So every time we remove one digit from the number. If you go for divided by 10, removing one digit. If you go for divided by 100, removing two digits. If you go for divided by 1000, removing three digits. So we have seen several examples with divided by operator. Through divided by operator, we got to know very clearly removing numbers, either one number or two numbers or three numbers. If it is divided by 10, removing one number. Divided by 100, removing two numbers. Divided by 1000, removing three numbers. In the same way, let's see another operator, mod operator. What this mod operator is doing? B8.java. So please observe. 1, 2, 3 mod vector. Everybody. 1, 2, 3 mod vector. If it is a mod vector, it will be giving a 3. The meaning of this is, what could be the remainder while dividing with 10? While dividing with 10, what could be the remainder? Remainder will be 3. You will be getting a 3. Mod operator always use a remainder. Mod operator giving a remainder. Please observe. 1, 2, 3 mod 10. You will be getting a 3. If at all you are using 1, 2, 3 divided by 10, you will be getting 1, 2. You can see the clear difference between divided by and mod. Let us see one more example on the same box. Let's go for 1000. Mod operator always gives a reminder. Mod operator always gives a reminder. You will be getting a 3 over here. You will be getting a 2, 3. If it is divided by 100, come on, what could be the reminder? Reminder will be 2, 3. So here, the reminder 1, 2, 3. Mod 1000, you will be getting a 0. I didn't save the class name. Mod 1000. 1, 2, 3. Please observe. So mod 10 means 3, the last digit. Mod 100 means 2, 3. Mod 1000 means 1, 2, 3. You should have a clear difference between mod operator and divided by operator. So in the plain words, if you go for divided by 10, it removes the last digit. If you go for mod 10, it returns the last digit.
if you go for divided by 100, it removes last two digits. If you go for mod 100, it returns last two digits. Let's see both together in the same program. For beat. The plain words, let's go for 1, 2, 3 is a number divided by 10. Mod 10. Same way, go for 100. One, two, three divided by 10, you will be getting 1, 2, 3 will be removing. 1, 2, 3 will be removing. If you go for 1, 2, 3 mod 10, you will be getting a 3, just 3. Here 3 is removing, here 3 only returning. Here 2, 3 removing, 2, 3 removing, you'll get a 1. Here 2, 3 will be returning. 2, 3 will be returning. If you go for divided by 10, divided by 10, so last digit is removing. If you go for mod 10, last digit only returning. If you go for divided by 100, last two digits removing. If you go for mod 100, last two digits only returning. Almost every number system logical coding programs required these two operators very extensively. Divided by operator and mod operator both required very extensively. So let's have a clear difference. 1, 2, 3 divided by 10, you will be getting just 1, 2. The first output is 1, 2. 1, 2, 3 mod 10, you will be getting a 3. 1, 2, 3 divided by 100, two digits are removing, you will be getting a 1. If you go for 1, 2, 3 slash, sorry, 1, 2, 3 mod 100, you will be getting last two digits. Let's see one more example in the same grounds, both the operators using together. Let us increase one more digit. I'll add two more states. Let's go for 1000. Again here 1000. So we know very well about what is the output of this. Divided by 10 means last digit removed. You will be getting output as a 1, 2, 3. The first output is 1, 2, 3. The second output, mod 10. If it is a mod 10, only last digit will be returning. It returns a last digit. Let's go for divided by 100. Last two digits are removing. You will be getting just 1, 2. You will be getting just 1. If you go for mod 100, last two digits are returning, that is 2, 3, 3, 4. Last two digits are 3, 4. Please observe. If you go for divided by 1000, you will be getting output as a 1. Divided by, it's removing. Go for mod. If you go for mod 1000, you will be getting 2, 3, 4. You will be getting 2, 3, 4. Through this example, you can have a clear difference between divided by and mod. Divided by operator, mod operator. If you know this one,
we can solve several examples. Let us see. I need to find out what could be the second digit, what could be the first digit in the given two digits number. In the given two digits number, what could be under units, what could be under tens. Like a so customer is giving two numbers. I need to find out what is the second digit, what is the first digit. How to find out? Let us consider the number is 47. Two digits number. Two digits number. Number is 47. Two digits number. How to find out what is the first digit? How to find out what is the second digit? The given number is 47. You need to identify first digit as 4, second digit as 7. It's very simple. Int num. Let's consider 47. This is the given number. So given digit is 47. Let's go for int num 1. I want to find out the last digit. Very easily you can get the last digit mod 10. Num divided by 10. You will be getting num mod 10. Num mod 10. You will be getting a 7. 7 is assigning to num 1. Let's go for num 2. Before going to num 2, let's go for num divided by 10. Now you can print num1 and num2. So what we are doing here, please observe. Given number is 47. Given number is 47. In this 47, if you go for mod 10, if you go for mod 10, you'll get 7 to the num1. 7 to the num 1. Then num divided by 10. 7 is removing. 7 is removing 4. 4 is assigning back to num. 4 is assigning back to num. Now num reinitialize it to 4. Num reinitialize it to 4. Then go for num mod 10. The last digit of num mod 10 is 4. So num 2 will be 4. Num 1 will be 7. It's very easy to identify B12. Now, I want to reverse. This is very important, guys. I just wanted to reverse the given two digits number. It is not ending with 0. Let us consider same type of program, a simple program. B13.java. Let us consider 47 only. I need to reverse. It should become a 74. How we can reverse a number? I just wanted to reverse a number. Number reversing. 47 should convert into 74. 47 should convert into 74. So given number is 47. Got it? So try to take the last digit. Num1 is a 7. So num1 is a 7. After getting a 7, what you can do is num1 is equal to num1 into 10 just go for num1 into 10. You will be getting num1 as a 70. Now, so here num is equal to num divided by 10. So earlier num was 4, 7. Now num will become a 4. Then 4, 4. Num is equal to num1 plus num. You can print num1. Just to print num. If you wanted, you can print num in the beginning. Then you can print in the... So please observe, initial num 47, guys, everybody. Initial num 47. 47 only printing, 47 only printing. Then reading last digit, num mod 10. If you go for num mod 10, you will be getting a 7. Num mod 10, you will be getting a 7. Then num1 is equal to num1 into 10, 7 into 10, 70. Num1 is a 70. Then go for num is equal to num divided by 10, you will get a 4. Num divided by 10, you will be getting 4. Now num is equal to 70 plus 4, you will be getting 74. It looks like a little difficult, but not. Very simple. Very, very simple. Somewhere semicolon is missing. Here. So to understand this properly, let's go for one more. Let's go for int given number is 27 or 28. The initial one is 28. So final it should become a 82. For that purpose, get the last digit. Let's go for last digit. How you can get the last digit? Come on. Num divided by 10. Sorry, num mod 10. Num mod 10 returning last digit. Then you can make last digit is equal to last digit into 10. So it will become a 80. Why we are making this as a 80, that you come to know. Now let's go for num is equal to remove the last digit. Removing the last digit can be done with the divided by 10. Now you can go for num is equal to last digit plus. No. The current num is 2. 2 is adding to the 80. 80 plus 2, 82. Num will become 82. First read the last digit. You will be getting 8 over here. Come on. Then we are bringing this as a 80 by multiplying with a 10. Then num is equal to 2. Why? Because divided by 10 means 8 is removing. Now,
with India.
What is the last digit? 80 plus 2, 82. This will become 82. Without a loop, I am developing this one. While using loop, this will be much more simpler. Let us use some loops. Then you can able to reverse much more bigger number. Initially, let's go for b15.java. I want to find out total number of digits available in the given number. Assume this is the given number. In this given number, total how many digits available? I just wanted to know digits count. Finding out digits count. Just to go for count is equal to 0. Just to while you whether num not equal to 0. Let's go for count plus plus num is equal to num divided by 10. Just to print the count. It is a simple way of finding out how many digits available in the given number. How many digits available in the given number? What we are doing? Initially count is 0. Initially count is 0. Num not equal to 0. Num not equal to 0. Go inside count plus plus. Incrementing count to 1. Incrementing count to 1. Num is equal to num divided by 10. We are removing one number, sorry, one digit. Num divided by 10, it removes one digit. One digit is removing, count is incrementing. Repeating again. In the second iteration, again increment the count and remove the second digit. Go to the third one. So again increment the count, remove one digit. Num is equal to num divided by 10. So every time one digit is removing and count is incrementing, I need to know how many digits are there in the given number. I'm just taking hard coded number 456758. Let's compile. You can see totally 6 digits are there. In the given number, totally 6 digits. I repeat one more time. Initially count is 0. Num is not equal to 0. Going inside, incrementing the count. Count is incrementing. Count will become a 1. Then num is equal to num by 10. Num will become a 4 to 5. 4, 5, 6, 7, 5. Go to the next iteration. Num not equal to 0. Again increment the count. The count will become a 2. Then num will become 4, 5, 6, 7. 4, 5, 6, 7. So num is not equal to 0. Going inside. Count will become a 3. Then num is equal to 4, 5, 6. Num is equal to 4, 5, 6. Every time we are removing one digit and the count is incrementing. Every time we are removing one digit and the count is incrementing. Same, almost the same kind of logic we can apply while reversing a number. Let us see how we can reverse a two digits number, three digits number, or any digits number reversing. B16. B16.java. Let's go for int num is equal to just two digits number. Just two digits number. Let's go for reverse num. Initially it is 0. Initially it is 0. Then go for while loop. Num not equal to 0. You can declare one more variable as a digit or maybe a last digit. Last digit. Read the last digit. You know very well about reading the last digit. Now, reverse num is equal to reverse num into 10 plus last digit. Reverse num, that is initially we are assuming 0. 0 into 10 plus last digit. Whatever last digit is there in the current iteration. Then you can go for num is equal to num divided by 10. Then you can print reverse num. So please observe, initially reverse num is 0. Num is equal to 34, going inside, last digit is a 4, last digit is a 4, reverse num is equal to, this completely 0, this is a 4, so reverse num will be 4, come on, reverse num is a 4, then num is equal to 34 divided by 4 is a 3. Num is equal to 3, reverse num is equal to 4. Going the second iteration, num is equal to 3. Because of num is equal to 3, it is going inside. Last digit will be 3. Last digit is a 3. Reverse num is a 4. 4 into 10, 40. 40 plus last digit is a 3. 43. Reverse num will become a 43. Then num is equal to 3 divided by 10 is a 0. 3 divided by 10 is a 0. In the next iteration, so because of num is equal to 0, it will come away from the while loop. It is coming away and reverse num is a 43. Reverse num is 43. It's very simple. Only the thing is, you should have a little idea about the loops. So definitely even non-computer science student also can understand the basics of the loops. We are getting 43. Let us analyze same type of program with 4 digits. Then you can easily understand. I'll copy the same program. Let us go for 4 digits number. Let's go for 3412. 3412 we have in us. Let us see in the first iteration. Num is a 3412. Reverse num is 0. Num is a 3412. Reverse num is 0. So going inside a while loop. Last digit is equal to 2. Everybody knows. last digit is a 2. Reverse num is equal to, already reverse num is a 0 in the first iteration, it will become a 0, last digit is 2. So reverse num will be 2. In the first iteration, reverse num is equal to 2. And what is the num? Num is becoming 341. Num is becoming 341. One iteration got over. This option. This is the status. Initially, please observe. Initial also I will represent. Before while loop, reverse num was 0 and num was 3, 4, 1, 2. Initially it was 0. This one 3, 4, 1, 2. After one iteration, reverse num became a 2, num became a 3, 1, 4. Now, let's see the next iteration. In the next iteration, num is 3, 1, 4, going inside, last digit will be 4. Last digit is a 4. What would the reverse num? Reverse num. The current reverse num is a 2, 2 into 10 is a 20, 20 plus last digit is a 4. You will be getting 24. Come on. Last digit is what? Sorry, 21. Three, four, one. Last digit is a 1, 2, 1. Now, this removing, last digit is removing. If last digit is removing, you will be getting 3, 4. This is the second iteration. While going to the third iteration, num is not equal to 0. Now num became 3, 4. The last digit is a 4. Reverse num is a 21. 21 into 10, 210, 210 into 4, 210 into 4, what would be 214? Then, because of divided by 10, it will become a 3. Come on. In the next iteration, num is a 3, last digit will become a 3, last digit is a 3. Reverse num is equal to 214 into 10, 2140, 2140 plus 3, 21, 2143. And the num will become a 0. If it is a 0, it is coming away. If it is a 0, it will come away. Very simple, very, very simple. Please observe, initially reverse num is 0. Reverse num is 0. Original number is this one. Reverse num is 0. Original number is this one. Then, in the first iteration, last digit is equal to 2. Last digit is equal to 2. Reverse num is equal to 0 plus 2. It will become a 2. Num will be 3412 divided by 10. You will be getting 341. You will be getting 341. One iteration got over. Reverse num became a 2. Num became a 341. In the second iteration, last digit will be 1. Come on. The last digit will be 1. Reverse num is equal to 2 into 10, 20. Plus 1, 21. Reverse num is 21. Num will become a 3. Why? Because we are removing 1. Through divided by 10, we are removing 1 digit. Through mod 10, we are reading 1 digit. We are reading last digit through mod 10. So we'll come back to the same type of program once again after developing few more examples. This is very standard. Every interviewer is asking how you can reverse a number. Number reversing purpose. Let's see one more example.
B18.java.
So here, I wanted to know sum of all the digits in a given number. Sum of all the digits in a given number. Assume there is one number. Inside that number, whatever digits are there, sum of all the digits. Let's consider int num is equal to 5, 6. 2, 3, 4, then 5, 6. Sum, so 2, 3, 5, 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 6, 16, 16 plus 3, 23. Programmatically, we need to find out sum of the digits in a given number. Sum of the digits in a given number. It's very simple. Let's go for int sum is equal to 0. Let's go for while num not equal to 0, sum is equal to sum plus, we know very well about reading the last digit. Go for reading the last digit. Every time, take the last digit. Then remove that last digit. That's it. Go for num. So very simple. Int num is equal to some number. Then sum is equal to 0. Sum is equal to 0 initially. Num not equal to 0. Go inside. Sum is equal to 0 plus 7. Sum will become a 7. Then num will become 2, 3, 4, 6. 7 is removing. 7 we already added to num. Remove the sum. In the next iteration, num is equal to 2, 3, 4, 6. 2, 3, 4, 6. Then go inside a while loop. Sum is equal to. So already sum is a 7. 7 plus, what is the last digit? 6. 7 plus 6, it is 13. So sum is becoming 13. Num will become 2, 3, 4. Num will become 2, 3, 4. 6 is removing. 6 is removing. Num is equal to 2, 3, 4. Come to the next iteration. Num is not a 0. Go for sum. 13 plus 4. The current num is 2, 3, 4. In the 2, 3, 4, last digit is 4. 13 plus 4, 17. Please observe. Then sum is equal to 17. Then remove that 3. So likewise, what we are doing, last digit add to sum. Then remove the last digit. Then again consider whatever last digit, add to sum, remove that key. Let's compile and run. You need to print the sum. I'm printing a num. Can see 20. Let's see one more example. B19. I just wanted to know whether given number is a given number, any number 3, 4, 5. Whether this number is a even number or odd number. Whether this number is a even number or odd number. Very simple, use mod operator with a 2. If remainder is 0, it is an even number. If remainder is 0, even number. Otherwise, it is an odd number. Let us check it out. What would be the remainder? What would be the remainder? Remainder is a 1. If remainder is a 1, definitely it is an odd number. Please observe. The same, let us check it out through a if block. Please observe. I'll take out this. I'll start the if block. Whether remainder is a 0 or 1. If it is a 0, then print the even number. Whatever number else or 1. It is an odd number. Just to check it out, given number, while dividing with the 2, what could be the remainder? While dividing with the 2, what could be the remainder? If remainder is 0, if remainder is 0, it will become an even number. If remainder is a 1, it will become an odd number. Remainder. Let's compile and run. The given number is an odd number. Let's see one more example in the same graph. I'm just changing the number. Let's go for 312. Definitely 312. Mod 2 returns 0. Mod 2 results 0. So the remainder will be 0, remainder will be 0 whenever you are dividing with 2. Mod operator tells about the remainder. Mod operator tells about the remainder. So original given number is 312. 312, if at all it is dividing with 2, the remainder will be 0. That is what telling by mod operator. Mod 2 is a 0, you will be getting even number. Let's compile. Even. I have a requirement of reading all 5 multiples from one number to another number. If I want to print every 5 multiple from given one number to another number. Let us see. P22. Let us consider num1. Maybe 31, num2 65. I just wanted to print from 31 to 65, whatever five multiples are there, all five multiples I have to find. Like a 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60. Five multiples, how we get? Let us run one for loop. Int I is equal to num1. I less than or equal to num2. Plus plus. If it is five multiple, print I value. Otherwise, print a simple program. I need to print all five multiples between two given numbers. Between two given numbers. First number says 31, second number is 65. First number is 31, second number is 65. How to print all five multiples, every five multiple between two? Just run the form starting from first number, ending till to the second number. Every time you can increment, every time you can increment, you need to use I over here. I mod 5. Whichever I divisible with 5, whichever I divisible with 5, mod 5 remainder 0, definitely it will be divisible with 5. Just to compile. Till to 65, all five multiples from one number to another number. How to print multiples for a particular number, that is 5. So let us see. I have another requirement. From two given number, from, let us consider first number is a bigger number. Maybe from 95 till to 21, you need to print all multiples of 7. Multiples of 7. Print the multiples of 7 from one number to another number. Something like a, in the reverse order. First number is a bigger number, second number is a smaller number. Int num1. Let's go for 7 multiples. Once you know the logic, you can implement very easily 7 multiples. 7 multiples. I is equal to num1, I greater than or equal to num2, I minus minus, I minus minus, I mod 7 is 0, I mod 7 is 0. Let us try to compile and run. Can see all 7 multiples from one number to another number. Let us develop once again reversing a number. Definitely we required some more explanation on So let's go for int num is equal to 2034. While reversing a number, 0 should not be in the rightmost. If 0 is in the rightmost, while reversing, you will be getting a different meaning. Please observe. If number having a 0 in the rightmost, then while reversing, you will be getting a different meaning. It may not be meaningful exercise. So take the number without a 0 in the rightmost. Now, initially, I'm going for reverse num is equal to 0. Let's go for int I is equal to num. Whatever num you have given, that is 2034. 2034 I am assigning to I. I will be 2034. Now I'll use the I inside a while loop. So please observe, I is one and the same of num. Come on. Whatever num value is there, same num value assigning to I. Inside a while loop, reverse num into 10 plus, you can go for the last digit through a mod 10. Then I is equal to I divided by 10. I'm not changing num. Num is remains the same. Let us print both num and reverse num. Num initial, whatever num value is there, that we are assigning to I. I'm not modifying num at all. I modified I only. Initial num value receiving into I, then I'm processing while loop through I. So let us see in the first iteration, guys. So under comments, I will be specifying iteration wise. Under first iteration, initially, reverse num is equal to, initially it was 0. In the first iteration, 0 plus 4. I think you can understand. Reverse num, I value 2034, the last digit is a 4. Reverse num is equal to, initially it was 0, 0 plus 4. Reverse num will become a 4. What could be the I value? Come on. I will become 203. I is equal to 203. This is about first iteration. Let's move to the second iteration. In the second iteration, what could be the reverse num? Reverse num is equal to, the current reverse num is a 4. 4 into 10, 40. And the current last digit is a 3. So reverse num is 43. What could be the I value? I will become a 20. We are removing last digit. This is about second iteration. Let's move to the third iteration. In the third iteration, reverse num is equal to, current reverse num is 43. 43 into 10. That is 430. 430 plus 0. 430 plus 0. Please observe. You will be getting 431. What could be the I value? I value will become a 2. Come on. This is about third iteration. Let's move to the fourth iteration. Reverse num is equal to reverse num 430 into 10, that is 4300. 4300 plus 2. Definitely 4302. Come on. Reverse num will become a 4302. 4302. I is becoming 0. Whenever I is becoming 0, while loop will be terminating. While loop is terminating. So you can see reverse 4302. Original number is 2034. Reverse num 4302. So I'm just ending the comments. Let's compile and run. Already comments ended. Original number is 2034. Reverse number is 4302. I repeat the same program once again with a bigger number. Observe everybody, D25 int num is equal to 2390456. Let's go for even 1. This is the initial number. The initial number assigned to initial number assigning to A. Let's go for reverse num also. Let us print both. Reverse num. Now we need to implement the logic. So original num value assigned to I. I is containing original num value 2390456. Reverse num is equal to 0. Let's go for while loop as long as I not equal to 0. Let while loop is equal to 0. As long as I not equal to 0, while loop will be 0. Now, reverse num is equal to reverse num in 10 plus last digit in the I. I'll take the last digit to mod 10. We know very well about the mod 10. Our session started with divided by and mod operator. Then I is equal to I divided by 10. So very simple. So first let us compile and run. Then I'll explain iteration by iteration. Iteration by iteration. Let's go for B25. Original number 2390456116 54093 2. Let's see in the comments we can go out. I is equal to then reverse num is equal to 0. These are the initial values. Let's see the first equation. Under first equation, reverse num is equal to reverse num initial value 0, 0 into 10, 0, 0 plus last digit is 1. Reverse num will become a 1. We substitute. Then I will become, what is the value? It will be 2390456. 2390456. Then go to the second iteration. In the second iteration, reverse num is equal to 1 into 10, that is 10. 10 plus 6 is 16. 1 into 10, 10 plus 6 is 16. Then I is equal to 2390456. This is about second iteration. Let us go for third iteration. In the third iteration, the current reverse num is 16. 16 into 10, 160. 160 is 5. 165. 165. So here 5 will be removed. In the third iteration. So go to the fourth iteration. I'll show you even fourth iteration also. By now, everybody might have got a clear about. So here 165 into 10 plus 4. 1654. So if you know this simple logic, this equation. Reverse num is equal to reverse num into 10. Yes. So initially I showed take the last digit into 10 plus the remaining portion while going for two digits. So we are doing like this. What is so here, whatever examples we have seen, the main very important examples we can consider like counting total number of digits in a given number. How to count, how to find out the total number of digits. The second one, sum of all the digits in a given number. Sum of all the digits in a given number. The third one, reversing digits in a given number. Reversing digits in a given number. These are all very, very important.